We wanted to be a leader in this area of having as little impact as possible on the environment. And at the same time, we saw that we were saving money because we basically burned, you know, less fuel in our aircraft as well, saving energy as well. So this makes perfect sense. And the benefit for the whole of the industry is actually that this will become an even more attractive proposition for customers to choose to go on holiday when we get this right. Very early on, we recognized that we wanted to lead in terms of having Europe's most carbon efficient operations within our airline, as an example. Once again, because it was good for the environment, but it was also something that saved cost for us as a company. And there's always more work to be done in this area. That's an ongoing thing we do. Today, we operate, for instance, to sell holidays to 6 out of the top 10 destinations when it comes to the highest level of water stress. And we are engaging, you know, very actively with governments and partners to make sure that we do what we can in order to preserve water in these destinations. And this is a challenge. But that's, you see, where our model makes also very much sense, because we work with something that is a core part of our strategy to have differentiated, unique hotel experiences. And the big benefit of that is that gives us also the control to influence the operations in those hotels, to make sure that we have mechanisms, that we have procedures in order to actually then reduce the level of the water that is needed as well. So it actually fits very much to the strategy we have, and we are using that influence quite a lot with our partners. If you disregard this issue about sustainability in the environment, you will not, in some cases, have a long-term business. The other point that is important is that the more you do in this area, I can almost guarantee you that your business will be a healthier, more profitable business, and a more attractive solution for our customer. Because, you see, our customers do care about these things, which means that they, as our suppliers and partners, need to recognize that. And most of them actually do that as well. And we are also clearly more keen to work with those players and those companies who take these issues seriously. I think there's a lot of things that still needs to be done in making sure that we have effective legislation within the area of sustainability, making sure that there is a level playing field, that where we think that the revenues and the funds of this should go into the environmental enhancement project that is out there as well, and also making sure that this is not only just a European issue, but actually a global issue. We can do more to helping them to understand that to have a level playing field when it comes to a system that once again incentivizes the good players who takes it seriously, and also penalizes the player who doesn't think that this is an issue as well. So we're trying to come up with a model where it's easy for us to say to a government that we are planning to come in here, we're looking to get perhaps 10,000, 20, 30, 40,000 customers into your destination, and we will show you and prove you that if we're doing this, there is a way by the effort of ourselves and yourself that actually this can be net beneficial for you as a country, as a destination, and also making sure that we are creating project that also is to the benefit of the sustainability and the environment locally. We should not be complacent in this area. There's so much more to go for. We got to continue to be innovative. We got to continue to be impatient in this area. It's not too late to do something about, you know, the environment as a whole, the climate change as a whole, I believe. I think we've been on a journey on this. We are leading in this area, but, you know, we can still do more.